Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a database server on Amazon AWS. I will connect to the database server using a client software called MySQL Workbench. Then I will create a database, a table, and also put some data into the table. I will also run some queries on the database. Database is an important part of IT infrastructure of all enterprises. Databases are used for inventory, accounting, HR, sales, marketing, reporting, and so on. Most of the applications used by enterprise organizations use databases in the background. So, I am at aws.amazon.com. I sign in with my account and it takes me to AWS Management Console. From there, I look for database service category and select RDS or Relational Database Service. Currently, I have no database instances under my account. So I select Create Database. At this time of recording, there are 6 database engines available under AWS: Amazon Aurora, MySQL, MariaDB, PostgreSQL, Oracle, and Microsoft SQL Server. Among these, Amazon Aurora and Oracle do not support free tier account, but all other engines do. After selecting a database engine, if I go to templates, then I can see availability of free tier templates under that engine. MySQL has free tier template. So I select MySQL database engine and free tier template. Then I give a name to this instance. And for credential, I create a master user. I take the default username, which is admin, and then set a password. For database instance class, I have only one option under free tier account. So I take it. For a storage, I take the default values. For database authentication, I select password authentication so that I can connect by using username and password. Also go to additional connectivity configuration and make the database publicly accessible. Then I go to additional configuration and remove automatic backup to avoid any charges. I can also disable manual version upgrade. Then I press on the Create Database button. It will take several minutes to finish creating the database instance. In the meantime, I will download and install MySQL Workbench. So I simply Google search and go to the download page of MySQL Workbench. Then I select the operating system of my computer and click on download. On the next page, it asks to log in or sign up. I can skip log in or sign up and download. When the download is complete, I install MySQL Workbench. I already downloaded and installed MySQL Workbench before, so I skip the rest of the installation. Then I run MySQL Workbench. On the AWS, the database instance has been created. Now I will need the endpoint of this database instance to connect to the database. I can get it from View Credential Details link and copy it. Or I can go to the instance details and find the endpoint under connectivity and security sections and copy it. To be able to connect to the database instance, I need to make some changes in the VPC security groups. So I open it. And then from the actions drop down, I select edit inbound rules. Then I change the source column value from custom to anywhere. This will allow connections from external sources. Now I run MySQL Workbench and from the welcome screen, I create a new connection. I give a name to this connection. And for the host name, I paste the endpoint that I copied from the database. Then I put the username and password that I created while creating a database instance. Then I test the connection and the connection was successful. Then I press OK. And it takes me to the MySQL Workbench query interface. I check existing databases. Then I create a new database. Then I use this new database. And I check for existing tables. Because it's a new database, so there is no table in the database. Then I create a new table called students. Then I insert 3 new records into the table. Then I retrieve data from the database by using select query. This is a test environment where I'm using the free tier account. So I go back to the database and delete the instance that I created. I also make sure that a snapshot is not saved. It will take some time to delete the database instance. The instance was deleted successfully. That is the end of this demo. I hope you found this video helpful. If you'd like to receive notifications on future videos, please make sure you're subscribed to my channel and set up notification by tapping on the bell. Thank you for watching.